We out here trying to tell you repent and keep God's law so you can get the kingdom of heaven. Right. That's our mission. Because guess what? Your pastors ain't out here doing it.
Right.
Rock Flow ain't out here doing it.
Right.
T.D. Jakes ain't out here doing it.
Right.
They want your damn money.
That's right.
We ain't out here asking for a dime. All we asking is for you to repent. God said he put a difference between us. But the white man wants you to think all black people the same. No, we are not. We are the Israelites and we different from all other people on the earth. Give me that.
Exodus chapter 11 and verse 7.
Read.
But against any of the children of Israel.
God said, but against any other children of Israel, these 12 tribes, what?
Shall not a dog move his tongue.
Not a dog, meaning another nation. They shouldn't even be speaking against us. Read.
Against man or beast.
All our beasts. Read.
That ye may know how that the Lord doth put a difference.
He do what?
Put a difference.
Jerry, God said God put a difference between who?
Between the Egyptians.
Between the Egyptians and a different group of black people. Read.
And Israel.
And Israel. Another set of black people. God
That's
said
right.
He said a difference. We are not the same.
Right.
They do things totally different from us. Matter of fact, they know we are not the same. You
right.
run into a real African today, they don't even like black people.
Right.
Because they know we ain't the same. God said we special. Go back to Deuteronomy 28.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68.
Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
So what's Egypt again? Egypt is a house of bondage, meaning slavery. Well, I say,
okay.
He's going to bring you into slavery again with
ships.
With what?
With ships.
How did we get over here?
Ships.
So Moses prophesied this 2,000 years ago, said if you don't keep God's commandments, these people, you're going to go on slavery and ships. And guess what? Thousands of years later, it happened just as he prophesied it.
Right.
Because slavery happened. But
right.
guess what? God showed Moses was going to happen to his people because we were disobedient. That's how we prove we the Israelites. The white man here, this ain't happened to him.
Right.
But therefore, he go around claiming to be you.
Right.
Claiming to be a Jew. Claiming to be God's people.
Bring it out.
And he know he the damn devil on the earth. He won't tell you nobody. He
right.
won't tell you we are far from monkeys and apes. Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again. With ships.
With ships. You said it yourself. We came over here on ships, proving that we are the Israelites.
That's right.
Read.
By the way, whereof I speak unto thee.
And is meaning our homeland, that we wasn't going what?
Thou shalt see it no more again.
Come on. If it ain't our homeland, we wasn't going to see it no more again. Hey, brother, come in, man. Come on and talk with us, man. Let me ask you a question. What's your name, man?
Dash.
Huh? Dash. Jacob. For the brother, we're going to go back real quick. Give me Deuteronomy 28:15, and we're going to come right back where we left off. So, right now, brother, come in. Look at this sign. Right here, it says the 12 tribes of Israel, right? We are the Israelites. So, Moses is talking to the Israelites. Watch this. Deuteronomy 28:15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
Read.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So, Dad, listen. Moses told the children of Israel, if you don't hearken unto God and keep his law, statutes, and commandments, what's going to happen?
To observe, to do all his commandments
uh-huh.
and statutes, which I command thee this day,
uh-huh.
that all these curses...
All of what?
All these curses...
All of what?
All these curses
uh-huh.
shall come upon thee... And overtake
thee. Hey, Daz, pay attention. Come on now. Hey, is the curse a good or a bad thing?
A bad thing.
So Moses said the curses was going to come upon the children of Israel if we didn't obey God's commandments. Now we're going to get two curses for you. Give me 16. We're going back to 68. Watch this.
Verse 16.
Read.
Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
Daz, let me ask you a question. Are we cursed in the city? Give me some ways we curse in the city.
Gentrification.
Okay, that's a good point. Yes. What else?
I mean, plenty reasons.
Give me one more.
Well, People so rich is dying.
Yeah, oh, well, shit, that's 100% correct. That, but guess what? Ouse makes us cursed in the city. Guess what? We on the bottom. Look where we at. We in the slums. Yeah. We on the bottom.
Right.
We sell drugs to each other.
Right.
We shoot each other over a pair of shoes. We
right.
kill each other for a color.
Bring it out.
We whore out our sisters.
Teach.
That's being cursed in the city.
Right. Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
Uh-huh.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
So, Dez, when was we cursed in the field? When we were picking cotton, right? So Moses said this would happen to the Israelites. That's how we prove we the Israelites today. Now
right.
go back to 68. Because you said we got here, like Sherry said. Sherry said we got here on what?
Ship.
You said the same thing right here. They docked right here. Guess what? Your history is in the Bible. And you ain't know it because the white man been telling you lies. The white man not going to come in and tell you this truth.
Right.
That's why we out here to tell you God chose you to be the greatest people on this planet.
Teach.
Not just no niggas and no bad bees.
Right.
We greater than that. We the children of the Most High God, the gods of this earth.
That's right. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Bring it out.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
With what?
With ships.
So it said God was going to bring the Israelites into slavery again with ships. With ships. That happened to us. That happened to our ancestors.
Right.
We are our ancestors. Read.
By the way whereof I speak unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
So meaning our homeland, which is Jerusalem, it said we wasn't going to see it no more again as a nation. Read.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Hold on, hold on. Who are we going to be sold to?
And ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
It says, come here. It said we shall be sold to who?
Your enemies.
That's who's our enemy?
Ourselves.
The slave owner. Who the slave owner? Don't be afraid to say it, man.
Bring it out.
Back here, Sherry. We ain't finished. Come on. What's his name? Don't be afraid to say it, buddy. Say his name.
White people.
That's right. Read that. What you got? Read that. Read that again.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
You was going to be sold unto your enemies. God said that was going to happen to who? The Israelites.
That's right.
Right here when they docked in Charleston, guess what? We were sold to our enemies.
Right.
Read.
For bond men.
For slave men.
And bond women.
And slave women.
And no man shall buy you.
Meaning nobody was going to redeem us from these curses. Because we had Martin Luther that tried to raise up, tried to save us.
Right.
We had, what's his name?
Marcus Garvey
raised up to try to save us. We had Harriet Tubman try to raise up and save us. But guess what? No one's going to save us but the black Messiah.
Right.
Jesus Christ.
That's
He's coming
right.
back to redeem his people. He's coming back to save us from the hand of our enemies.
Right.
That's what he said. Give
right.
me that in Luke 1:68. Come on over here. We ain't going to bite. We ain't going to bite. We out here for y'all. We are here to teach y'all the truth.
Right.
It said, Christ said that he's going to redeem us. Watch this. Luke 1:68.
Luke chapter 1 and verse 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
No, blessed be the Lord God of all nations.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
No, blessed be the Lord God of the white man.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
It said, blessed be the Lord God of who?
Israel.
Who?
Israel.
The 12 tribes of Israel. God is only for these people.
That's right.
Don't let nobody tell you different. Read.
For he hath visited and redeemed his people.
Uh-huh. His people. Hold that. Give me Jeremiah 31 and 1. Because it says he's visited and redeemed his people.
Bring it out.
His people. Not all people. His people.
Right.
Guess what? His people are here in the ghettos and don't even know it because the white man been lying to us for so long.
Right.
Because he been telling you he is God's people. That's a damn lie. We are God's people. Read.
Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 1.
Read.
At the same time, saith the Lord, will I be the God of all the families of Israel.
So he's going to be the families of all nations.
of all Israel.
No, or the Chinese man.
Of all Israel.
No, the Japanese man.
Of Israel.
God said he's only going to be for the families of Israel, the 12 tribes. That's it.
That's right.
He ain't the God of nobody else.
Right.
He's the God of these people right here.
Right.
He's the God of these people on the bottom.
Right.
That's who he's the God of. Go back where you was. Go back. Hey, little man, what's going on, man? Come on and lunch up to. Hey, what's your name, buddy?
Trayvon.
Huh?
Trayvon.
Trayvon. Come on over here. Let me ask you a question real quick. Let me ask you a question. What color you? What color? How you doing, man? I'm Jacob. Trayvon. What color do you think Christ is? We coming back to you, sir. You do not know? You don't know what color Christ is? Okay. What color you think he is, Sherry? You thought he was white, right? That's the image they betrayed us, right? That's the image they showed us on TV, movies, shows. They say he a white man. But that's not so according to the Bible. Finish that out and we gonna get the color of Christ. Read that.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people.
Uh-huh.
And hath raised up an horn of salvation.
Which is Christ. Read.
For us in the house of his servant David.
Read.
As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets.
Guess what? All the prophets stated in the Old Testament, Christ was going to come and do what?
And he hath raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began.
Uh-huh.
That
the Israelites should what?
That we should be saved from our enemies.
That's Christ's whole mission.
That's right.
That's what Christ is coming back to do. To save us from the hand of our enemies. To save us from getting shot down in the street by the police. To save us from them locking us up in prison and we innocent.
Right.
We are going to be saved from killing each other.
Right.
That's what Christ is coming back to save us from the hand of our enemies.
That's
He's
right.
To save us from the hand of the devil white man.
Right.
That's his purpose. Any more on that? Mm-hmm. Read.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
Guess what? Who hates us? Let me ask you, what'd you say your name was again?
Trayvon.
Who hates us?
Bring it out.
Who hates the black people? Take your time. I'm gonna ask you, Shay. Who hates the white or who hates the black people?
Bring it out.
Come on over here. That's right. Come Bill. That's the truth. They hate us.
Right.
God said he is gonna come and save us from all those that hate us.
That's right.
Guess what? We out here showing you love. That's what we out here doing. We out here trying to tell you repent and keep God's law so you can get the kingdom of heaven.
Right.
That's our mission. Because guess what? Your pastors ain't out here doing it.
Right.
Rock Flow ain't out here doing it.
Right.
T.D. Jakes ain't out here doing it.
Right.
They want your damn money.
That's right.
We ain't out here asking for a dime. All we asking is for you to repent.
Right.
Read.
To perform the mercy promised.
Give me Revelation 1 and 1. Give me Revelation 1 and 1. Now, Sherry, you said Christ, the image they were showing is white, right? Is that true? You don't know. How about you? How about you? What'd you say, Jamal?
Trayvon.
You think Christ white? You said yeah?
Okay.
Read.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
Jerry, it says the revelation of Jesus Christ, meaning he's going to reveal what Christ looks like. The Bible is going to reveal what Christ looked like. Read.
The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
Read.
And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
So John was going to write down everything he's seen. So guess what? John seen Christ and he wrote down what he looked like. Read that, 14.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
Read.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Hey, let me ask y'all a question over there. Who got woolly hair on the earth?
Black
people.
Who? Black people.
Black people. He has woolly hair, Reed.
As white as snow.
As white as snow. I look like you got some white hair over there. You got some white over there? Yeah, come on over here, man. You. Come on, we ain't gonna bite. Your leg hurt, but I think you got some white. I think you got some white woolly hair over there, just like Christ. You say, yeah, you do? Yeah, I know. I think I can see it from here. I think I got that 2020 vision, man. Read that.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And it said his eyes were as a flame of fire, because guess what? His first miracle, he turned water into wine. Guess what he did? He sipped the wine. Give me
right.
That in Genesis.
Genesis.
That's why his eyes was red. Read.
Genesis chapter 49 and verse 12.
Read.
His eyes shall be red with wine.
His eyes shall be what?
Red with wine.
Said Christ's eyes was going to be red with wine. Go back to Revelation.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
Read.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Who got woolly hair? Black people got woolly hair. That's right. Read.
As white as snow.
Right.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
As a flame of fire because he drunk wine. Read.
And his feet.
And his what?
And his feet.
Hey, go ahead.
And his feet are like unto fine brass.
Hey, Sherry, what color is brass?
Brass? From?
Yeah.
I don't know.
What color is brass, Sherry?
Brass.
Huh? Promise.
Right.
So that kills it already. It said his feet. Your feet the same color as the rest of your body, right?
Yeah.
So let's see how brown or black Christ was. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Uh-huh.
As if they burned in a furnace.
Sherry, when you take anything and burn it in the furnace, what color do you get?
Black.
Christ is a black man.
That's right.
After Lord. He ain't no white man with stringy hair.
Right.
No dog hair.
Right.
He ain't no white man with dog hair and blue eyes.
Teach.
He a black man with woolly hair. Just
right.
Like you said, black people have woolly hair.
Right.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.